is Bloomberg UTV.
Mr. Godrej, thank you very much for speaking to us. So the theme for today is the next decade. And I think what we're trying to understand here is what are groups like yours, and in the context of leading organizations in the emerging markets, doing and preparing on how they're preparing themselves for the opportunities that lie ahead. So before I come to that, let me take you back. As always, it's good to bring in a little bit of history. The year 2000, the millennium year, as we called it, most of us, if I remember correctly, were all thinking about the Y2K problem. And, you know, people were thinking systems would shut down. So that sort of preoccupied many of us. And then, of course, the opportunity slowly started. But those, of course, at that time, the markets were not looking good. The world had just come out of a big dot-com bust, and things were just beginning to pick up. How were things looking for the Godrej Group at that time, and how did things move on from then?
Well, you were right. Y2K was a bit of a question mark. Actually, nothing really negative happened. It went through quite well. But I think what really Y2K did for India was that a lot of our IT companies first got the large contracts for outsourcing, etc. So it put our IT industry on the map. I think it helped put India on the map a little bit too. And we've had a fabulous decade. But I think the next decade is going to be much better than the last decade for India.
So when we came into 2000, not that you must have had a next decade plan for 2000 to 2010, but what can you define or lay out what the Godrej Group looked like, and what are the changes that have happened since then?
Well, our sales were about a fourth of what they are today. We've grown, about quadrupled in the last decade. Profits have also grown very considerably. I think we were pleasantly surprised by the strong growth of the Indian economy, especially the latter half of the last decade. Also, the confidence in the economy in India, both consumer confidence as well as investor confidence, grew tremendously. And I think we are seeing a much more confident country, a country that expects to do extremely well over the next 2 to 3 decades. And I think that itself creates a momentum which will add tremendous value.
And if I may ask, I'd delve a little deeper into that. Can you tell us a little more about the businesses? I mean, obviously, you've been in the same business lines, but you've obviously grown within that. But what are the changes that have happened within that in terms of partnerships, in terms of brands brought in?
Well, we entered into some new partnerships. We entered into a joint venture with Tyson, a joint venture with Hershey, two new partnerships during the last decade. We did not enter any new businesses. We think the businesses we already are in have such great scope for growth that we wish to concentrate on the business. Of course, we are in many businesses, but we wish to concentrate on the business. The one business which I think grew tremendously over the last 10 years, and which I think will be one of our most important businesses over the next decade, is our property development business. We're putting a lot of emphasis on that business. We think it will create tremendous growth. And so that's the only major business. It existed prior to the last decade, but it grew a lot in the last decade.
Right, so you talked about partnerships, and if I may ask you a little more on that, you know, between consumer products and foods, for instance, what are the changes that have happened, and what has driven the partnerships that you've secured, and the ones perhaps that have not worked out as well?
Well, during the last decade, there's no partnership that did not work out.
I think the one
before the last partnership, decade. They worked out. I wouldn't say they didn't work out, but they were restructured. But that was in the 90s. Yeah. In the last decade, all our partnerships have worked well. The new partnerships have been forged because we feel having a joint venture partner will add a lot of value to the business. So we tend to give, say, half the shareholding, roughly half, it depends, 50, 51, depends on the circumstances, to the partner. But we expect that our share will be worth much more than if we had kept 100%. So that's the thinking behind it. Because they bring in technology. For example, we have a joint venture with Tyson in our poultry business. Now, we did not have much expertise in the past in animal proteins, in meat products, etc. Tyson is the world's biggest company in the field. So it made sense to tie up. Again, we acquired a company in confectionery called Nutrien a few years ago. And then Hershey approached us for whether we would like to discuss a possible joint venture. We didn't sort of open it up to many potential partners, but we discussed with Hershey and we came to terms and initiated a joint venture. Both of them, we think, are adding a lot of value and will continue to add value.
If we were to look at soaps, for instance, I mean, you've not had a partnership in recently, but what has been driving growth or what has driven growth in substantial terms?
Well, I think in our consumer products businesses, growth has been moderate, 15-20% per year, driven by the strong Indian economy, driven by strong consumer confidence. I expect those businesses will continue to grow at that moderate rate. There are other businesses in our group which have grown exponentially over the period. Property development, I mentioned to you, was one of them. There are other businesses such as we have a process equipment division which supplies a lot of equipment to refineries and petrochemical projects, etc. That's been growing very well. So there are many businesses which have a faster rate of growth. The FMCG and consumer durable business, to my mind, will continue at a growth rate of between 15-20% or thereabouts.
Did we go into, and this is really a question, into the millennium decade, if one may call it that, thinking that the multinational company, whether as represented by Unilever in India or Procter & Gamble or Reckitt-Benckiser, would swamp the market or put Indian players or traditional Indian players such as you under pressure?
That was perhaps one of the concerns in the 90s. But I don't think that was the concern the last decade. By the last decade, Indian business was extremely confident of global competition and had modified itself sufficiently to take on competition. I think Indian companies now are extremely competitive, globally competitive. And I think in the next decade, you will see an even larger thrust in globalization among Indian companies.
Right. So on that note, we take a break. But I'm going to come back and ask you now, how are we going to collect all these forces to fight or if engage in the next round of battles? Stay with us. You're watching The Next Decade with Adi Godrej, Chairman of Godrej Industries.